Hello, it's me, Hioska, from Marijuana Garden.
Multipotentiality, polymath, multipotentialite. Multipotentiality is an educational and psychological term referring to the ability of a person, particularly one of intellectual or artistic curiosity, to excel in two or more different fields. It can also refer to an individual whose interests span multiple fields or areas, rather than being strong in just one. Such individuals are called multipotentialites. On the contrary, those whose interests lie mostly within a single field are called specialists. While the term multipotentialite can be used interchangeably with polymath or Renaissance person, the terms are not identical. One need not be an expert in any particular field to be a multipotentialite. Other terms used to refer to multipotentialites are scanners, slashers, and multipods, among others. While there is some dispute as to the degree of prevalence of this phenomenon, it is a significant problem for those who experience it. It can lead to overscheduling, high stress levels, confusion, paralysis by analysis. It can also generate impulsive or conformist choices in gifted children. Also to feelings of social alienation, purposelessness, apathy and depression in the brightest of adults. Boredom is also a frequent occurrence in multipotentialites who have already mastered or learned everything they desire to know about a particular topic before moving on. Leonardo da Vinci may be the best historical example of an acknowledged genius who struggled with the difficulties associated with multipotentiality. He failed to complete many of the projects he started, and has been quoted as saying, "I have wasted my hours and I have offended God and mankind because my work did not reach the quality it should have." Other notable multipotentialites throughout history are of Rose, Thomas Jefferson, Benjamin Franklin, René Descartes, Sir Isaac Newton, Aristotle, and Archimedes. The term multipotentialite comes from Emily Wapnick and her website Potalike. It stems from the psychology term multipotentiality. The best definition I found came from an article titled, "Multipotentiality" by Tamara Fisher. Tamara Fisher wrote, "Multipotentiality is the state of having many exceptional talents, any one or more of which could make for a great career for that person. Gifted children often, though of course not always, have multipotentiality. Their advanced intellectual abilities and their intense curiosity make them prime candidates for excelling in multiple areas. This can be both a blessing and a curse. On the bright side, they have many realistic options for future careers. But on the downside, some of them will struggle mightily trying to decide which choice to make. Particularly in the last couple years of high school and the first couple years of college, this monumentous decision with so many great possible outcomes can be a source of debilitating stress. The choice is exhausting and stressful, as one of my students said this year. Are you a multipotentialite? If so, you are special. No worries, being a multipotentialite implies a lot of fun. The world will judge you, but hey, they judge you anyway. They will tell you to find and follow your true and unique passion. Find that thing and let it kill you if you accept a Bukowski-like formulation. You are not constructed that way. You need to explore. You get bored and you need to explore more. That's fine. You are a multipotentialite. Just like Da Vinci, Archimedes, Newton. Look at Theismann. He is, of course, Leonardo. He was a genius, a Renaissance person who changed the world. Keep in mind that not every Renaissance person was a multipotentialite. Leonardo was an expert in so many areas: science, art, architecture, music, mathematics, engineering, literature, anatomy, geology, astronomy, and the list can go on. His thoughts were way ahead his time, being now considered a truly visionaire. Did you visit Louvre in Paris? Did you see that remarkable and still mysterious painting called Gioconda? Well, the genius behind it was Da Vinci, and he stays behind many more masterpieces. Did you have a feeling that you also can't find a place in a single domain and must explore more in order to satisfy your inner peace? Then you are a multipotentialite, too. Today, Leonardo is widely recognized as one of the most diversely talented individuals ever to have lived in the world. Think about it and stop taking count of people's word. Focus on a thing, try to master it, go on if you get bored. It is not a problem. This is the way you are constructed. You can change the world. Yes, like Leonardo. This world needs you as a multipotentialite. It also needs specialists, to work in complex teams, helping and completing each other. A multipotentialite can offer a larger view and also foresight. A specialist can focus better on a specific task. This is wonderful. There is a sword with two blades here. A multipotentialite will explore more domains and will get a great amount of beautiful information. This sounds excellent for happiness. But he or she will also have to deal with depression, inadaptability, boredom. Life will be a big mess if no well handling is done. The 8 Multipotentialite Superpowers. 1. Contextual thinking. Multipotentialites are able to see the broader implications of a problem, and can therefore make smarter, more informed decisions. 2. Modes of thought. A background of multidisciplinary exploration means that multipotentialites are able to speak the language of people in different fields. The ability to shift between modes of thought allows us to translate between groups, help them understand each other, and work with big teams. 3. Wearing many hats. A multipotentialite knows how to do many things well, which means that we rarely have to seek outside help. We may want to, but rarely do we have to. 4. Fast skill acquisition. A multipotentialite is so accustomed to diving into new disciplines and acquiring knowledge, that we become skilled at the process of learning. The more experience you have being a beginner, the faster getting good becomes. The experience of tackling many subjects also means that we are less intimidated when facing new problems. We've got the confidence from years of picking things up to know that we can figure it out. Also, the truth is that multipotentialites rarely start from scratch. Most skills are transferable, and we often build off of past knowledge. A multipotentialite is also fiercely passionate about his pursuits, almost to the point of obsession. This kind of passion fuels self-learning. It means that we devour information and can reach a high level of proficiency fast. 5. Impact/inspiration. Being, as a multipotentialite, passionate doesn't just lead to fast skill acquisition. The enthusiasm that multipotentialites have for their interests makes them excellent leaders that other people want to band around. Knowledge is important, but I, as a multipotentialite, would argue that enthusiasm is more valuable since it reaches people on an emotional level. 6. Concoction. A multipotentialite is a schemer. We love coming up with new ideas and bringing projects to life. When I was a kid, I was constantly inventing OSA projects. There were plays, gymnastic shows, a kid's news program, fortune-telling and origami in the park, punk bands, websites, short films, and clubs. This pattern has continued throughout my life. Often when I look around and feel displeased with the existing options, I, as a multipotentialite, create my own. Multipotentialites are constantly looking to invent better, more fun ways of doing things. 7. Idea synthesis. Probably the coolest multipotentialite superpower is the ability to combine disparate fields and create something entirely new at the intersection. Would define innovation as taking knowledge in one area and applying it to solve a problem in an entirely unrelated field. The intersections are where new ideas are born. New ideas don't come from textbooks. With so many fields to draw from, multipotentialites have a lot of potential intersections to explore. 8. Adaptability. Ability to morph into whatever you need to be in a given situation. Barbara Scher, in her book Refuse to Choose, use all of your interests, passions, and hobbies to create the life and career of your dreams, called these people scanners. Steve Jobs once defined creativity as connecting things, and said that sadly, Most people don't have enough dots to connect because they haven't had many diverse experiences. Check out the whole quote, it's great. Innovation happens when you take knowledge from one field and use it to solve a problem in a completely unrelated field. To stifle your putty-like nature is a crime, not just in terms of limiting your own potential, but to society as a whole. As multipotentialites, we must use our gift to innovate. It's in our genes. Innovation is the reason you've been blessed with this trait, and it's what you've been called on to do. Never forget that. Are you a multipotentialite? It's about 10 to 15% of general population demonstrate multipotentialite characteristics. You might be a multipotentialite if you dive into a topic deeply but eventually grow tired of it and move on. Have divergent interests like business and art. Change jobs every 3-5 years because you grow bored with the area. Been referred to as a Renaissance man or woman. The problem is the current economy wants specialists. Previously, I wrote a post called, "Are you a generalist or specialist?" and I got lots of feedback from people who are generalists. They commented that they are no longer sought after in today's highly specialized work environment. Society tells us that we are supposed to have one passion. That does not work for multipotentialites. Thank you.